This is Wale Kenzo for Fox Sports Radio, 96.9 FM and 1340 AM, Hopewell, Virginia. I'm here with my man Glenn. Glenn Thomas, what's going on, Glenn?
Nothing much, man. Day 10 of Washington Redskins training camp. We saw a lot of things in training camp that's been interesting. One thing to note is that all three quarterbacks didn't have a good day again. Another good day where all three quarterbacks, they struggled a little bit.
Yeah, I agree. I thought Colt McCoy being the number one quarterback on the depth chart for this team, it came out a couple of days ago. I thought he looked bad compared to the rest. I thought that we're going to grade the individuals today. I thought the rookie Dwayne Haskins looked the best.
Yeah, Dwayne had a good day today hitting receivers. You see his ball is coming out a little bit quicker than it was earlier in camp 10 days ago. A lot of things were late. You also see today, which was surprising, the ones, Case Keenum started with ones today instead of Colt McCoy. We know that it came out on the depth chart, quote unquote, came out, and that Colt was number one. But today, Case started with the first team. Didn't look too bad. A lot of different things that the Washington Redskins are trying to do to get the quarterback some room to throw the ball. And some receivers dropped some balls today that they shouldn't have dropped. Running backs dropped some balls today that they shouldn't drop. So there's some things they got to work on heading into the first preseason game in the next couple of days against Cleveland.
And Jay did say this in his pre-press conference before camp started today. He did state that, you know, the depth chart is just something that's right up for reporters and media. He didn't pretty much look at it like, okay, this is the actual God-given roster or, you know, depth chart for the season.
Yeah, you got to do that because you want to create competition. You want some guys you leave off the depth chart or leave down, so you want them to work harder to move themselves. To work themselves up. You got some guys that you need to put on a depth chart or need to see a depth chart so they can build confidence in the program. And so you want guys to be able to work there. And Jay said it from the beginning of camp. He's going to give these guys quarterback opportunities to win the job. He's also going to give the running backs the opportunity to win the job.
Okay. So now quarterback speaking, like, who were you impressed with in camp today?
Today, Monte Nicholson, man, as far as defensive-wise, Monte Nicholson, he showed his aggressiveness. He showed several times he could have killed Paul Richardson a couple plays if they were tackling because the ball was thrown across the middle. He made a good run. He made a good fit run there coming up on the line. So Monte Nicholson, you know, has been very quiet. You know, everybody knows about his offseason stuff and last season, how he ended last season. But this camp and up to day 10 of the camp, Monte's been doing pretty well.
Yeah, I like Monte. Also, you know, I've always been a guy for Robert Davis. I like the wide receiver.
Right.
You could tell for me. I tore my ACL years ago playing basketball. When I look at Robert Davis, I do see a guy that you could tell is coming off an injury.
Yeah.
But what I like about him is his hand ability. I love his hands. He catches everything that goes to him in his area. So I like what I saw from a kid that had a devastating injury last season, and now he's back and he's kind of, you know, he's showing progress. He's showing he's becoming a better wide receiver. That's when obviously a guy, Jimmy Moreland, the guy from JMU, like he continues to stand out as a cornerback, a guy to me that's going to be pushing some of the starters for playing time in the regular season.
He is. He's a smart young guy from JMU. He pushes guys. He works hard. He stays after practice sometimes, and he does what he needs to do. He's listening. He saw him today communicating with Holcomb on the defense, so he knows his calls. So he's smart in that aspect, and I think he will find himself being in the right spot. And when he gets the opportunity, he'll take advantage of the opportunities that he has.
Yeah. So, looking at the offensive line situation, what do you think that's looking for in terms of, like, we're not having Trent, left tackle position?
They looked a little bit better today. These quarterbacks were able to get the ball off on 11-on-11, and which in previous days, they wasn't able to do so. Saw a couple times when the defense was dialed up all the way, they was able to stop the defense a couple times. There was some other times on the offensive side of the ball that the defense had to wait. It would have been sacked. Dwayne Haskins would have been sacked a couple times. What I liked was I didn't see anything coming from the left side that was blind and to kill a quarterback.
Yeah.
So that lets you know your left tackle is working up a little bit and getting a little bit better.
Yeah, I want to see that left guard competition, you know, manifest itself to see which player will be that left guard for the Washington Reds. Because obviously Eric Flowers is a guy they're trying to play at that position. I want to see Wes Martin. I want to see what the young boys want to do. You know, because that's a guy that a lot of people are banking on, Wes Martin.
Wes Martin did a good job on one-on-ones today. When we saw one-on-ones with the offensive line and defensive line, Wes Martin was able to stop your Ryan Andersons and some of those guys a couple times. And, you know, a couple times Ryan Anderson got a win there. But I'd like to see Wes Martin continue to fight. You know, Sheriff today on one-on-one drills was dominating. But I tell you, on the defensive side, Tim Settles. Settles on the one-on-one drills, you can start seeing the get-off is getting better. You're starting to see he's starting to understand it a little more. We interviewed him a couple of days ago, and he says the game is starting to come easy to him. It's starting to come – it's starting to slow down a little bit. So he's getting more focused and understand things more as year number two. So I think he's going to have a great year for the defensive line for the Redskins. But the offensive line, still a little bit work. You can see that the defense has been dialed down just a little bit to help accommodate the offensive line.
Well, that was day 10 of Skins training camp. Make sure you keep tuning in to Fox Sports Radio, 96.9 FM, 1340 AM, Hopewell, Virginia. I'm Wally.
I'm Glenn. Make sure you check out All Things Everything Podcast. Make sure you subscribe on Instagram, Google Play, Stitcher. Check Wally and Ray and the crew out each and every week on iTunes. All Skins Everything. Make sure you subscribe. All right.